strangers in here today, and I'm gonna be honest, the decibel level was right about on par with a normal show. So if you guys could cut the crap and really act like your hands make loud noises, that'd be awesome. Welcome to Attack of the Show!
A little better.
Man, he's a jerk in person, too. We're TV's only source for all the stuff you care about. I'm Kevin Pereira. It's good to see you. Thanks for coming on out. Thank you.
Candace Bailey. We are coming to you live from the G4 Studios in Los Angeles.
Hey, on the old program today, Mark Ruffalo is here live.
I like how you rolled your arm.
Thank you. Give him a little trill. The new Incredible Hulk is making his directorial debut with an independent film, Sympathy for Delicious. I'll probably ask him a question about it. And in Game Break, we dive into the new Mortal Kombat, and I will rip Blair Hutter's spine from his body.
Oh, that sounds horrifying.
I will also ask him questions about the game. It's incredible. I will do both of those.
Okay, you do that.
Okay.
Plus, Allison Hayeslip checks in from the set of Fast Five in Hotlanta.
Hello!
Where Vin Diesel and Paul Walker are driving cars and looking good doing it.
Oh, someone's got a crush.
Not really.
Okay.
Then in today's Gadget Prawn, we have the G-Slate Android tablet from LG.
What?
It's got 4G compatibility plus dual cameras for face or crotch time.
Oh, that's nice.
Was it supposed to be capability?
What'd you say?
Compatibility.
Oh, I wouldn't have even noticed.
You know, whatever. Yeah.
You just threw yourself under the Greyhound. That was nice.
Well, I was reading on Twitter that somebody made my mess ups into a drinking game. So I'm just trying to let you guys drink more.
Okay.
Shots for all.
The audience has now blacked out. Good night, everybody.
The point. Behold, we found internet.
And round and round and round them we shall go. Should do that. Can we do that tomorrow? I think we should get a tray of shots, and then for tomorrow's show,
every time
whenever there's a flub, we take one.
Wait. Do I have to take one?
Yes.
Well, of course, the whole show is going to be flubbed if every second I've taken a shot.
Right, that's the point. By the time it's epic fail, you're going to be in a puddle of your own vomit and urine. It'll be hilarious. We won't even run the clip. We'll just have the header and a shot of you.
We can only do it if it's like a half beer shot or something.
We'll do it with beer shots. That's fine. Light beer shots.
Light beer.
Mm-hmm.
Michelob Ultra.
Can we do this legally? We'll sign whatever. I'll drive her home. I'll be good, I swear. All right, we'll figure it out. That's tomorrow. Today, let's have some fun. Let's start off with number 5, everybody. Playgrounds. You know playgrounds?
Yeah.
Yeah?
I know they're for kids.
I believe they're for kids as well.
And adults wishing to kill themselves. That just kills me to see. His days of jungle gyms are over.
Yeah, but on the bright side, his days of murder ball have just begun. It's a good sport. That's a good sport.
We call Wednesday hump day because it's the halfway point of the week.
Too soon. I'd make that joke as he's being wheeled into ER. Like, I don't care. It's funnier on the way in. Yes, in Turkey, though, Candace, with regards to hump day, the gentleman there, they call it hump day because it's an opportunity to do the Humpty dance.
Mm.
Fun fact.
While listening to the toe-tapping tunes of the reggae rapper
Lorna.
Lorna.
I call that the Turkish delight.
Also Turkish birth control, because there's no way that dance party will ever be co-ed.
Well, probably not consensually, but yeah. They did own a truck. And at number 3, we have another video from our second favorite German slingshot maker.
The man behind the slingshot channel seems determined to prove that slingshots can do whatever guns can do. At this point, we're pretty convinced that he's right.
Hello and welcome to the Slingshot channel. Well, this Easter Sunday, I want to present to you a new invention of mine. It's the first full auto slingshot crossbow. firing single shots, it's easier to do this like this, so you don't use the crank, but you just, you know, put in here. So we go shot, 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 shot. So now we will go for full auto, which isn't full auto, it's really a repeating process. So we use the crank for that. One more go with full auto. That's fun.
President Obama. I'm writing a letter. You should totally draft that guy and use his slingshot technology for the army because it's totes
awesome. I don't think he can be drafted, Kevin. He's German.
Oh, so that... Wait, Germans are the enemy, right? Yeah. My bad. I'm sorry. Dear President Obama, you should bomb Germany lest their slingshot technology destroy us all. XO! Kevin and Candace, if you want to sign right there.
I'm good. You just send that off yourself.
I put the little X there for your name, though. That's where you sign next to.
It's more powerful coming from just
But I'm going to mail this to the president. So it's going to stay on the envelope. It's going to say, to president.
Great. Just mail it just like that. Well done, Kevin. Well done.
Okay, thank you. I'll just sign it for you, then. Candace Paley.
Are you going to rip it off?
I foiled my own plan! I just drew a penis on the paper. There was really nothing there. I'm sorry.
Kevin.
But I'm going to send it. I'm going to send it.
I need to ask you a very serious question.
Oh, okay. Twice. Once in church.
Not that.
Okay, what else?
Not that.
What else?
Is there anything more terrifying than elephants?
Yeah. Lots of things. I think most things, really, if you think about it for a second, there's a lot of things that are more terrifying than elephants.
Well, not for this guy.
I think, just so you know, other things that guy is terrified of, the circus, the movie Dumbo, Donald Trump. Just so you
Why
know.
Donald Trump? Because the Republican mascot is an elephant. I get it.
No, have you seen Donald Trump? He's just scary. Look at it, his hair is like... That's like some super alien fiber.
Still ahead, a large man on a tiny scooter.
Mass times acceleration equals something amazing. Yay! Number one ATN, stick around.
Today's ATN featured Turkey's finest five-man jam. We're wondering, what's the name of their dance? Tweet us your responses at AOTS, hashtag OMGROFLOL. If your response makes us do a jig, we'll feature it on Friday's show.
Yes, indeedy. Today's number one around the net features two great tastes that taste great together. Fat guys and little scooters.
Let this serve as cautionary tale. No matter what kind of shape you're in, if you're going to ride a scooter, always make sure to keep your balance.
He broke his own fall with his fat. You know what I'm saying? I'm sorry. I had to. Because...
No. Someone clear the breakables.
Okay, the entire set is breakable, Candace.
Yeah.
Who let this... Sir? Excuse me? Buddy? Hey? So can we just... I don't know, let's just get this over with. We know how this bit ends, right?
Okay, yeah, we all know you're just going to scoot around until you fall over and hurt yourself again.
Yeah, so if we could just
go ahead and do it.
Do that. I mean,
but carefully.
Oh. Okay. Wait, I think he's actually going to do it. Don't do it. Hey, buddy, you don't have to hurt yourself. Don't. There's no need. Don't, think about your family.
Don't do it.
Do you have a family? Think about someone else's family. Think about any family. Please don't.
So
I think he's going to do it. Guys, what? What the?
Where did Vin Diesel?
He exploded into an action star.
That was so weird.
I'll be honest. Vin Diesel in this bit makes about as much sense as him having 40 arms and legs. So okay. At this point, why not?
But for the record, I am not cleaning that up. Oh, gross.
To get your daily viral fix and to check out all the viral videos we have to offer,
that
go to g4tv.com/ around the net.
That is so scary.
What's going on?
Hey, Kevin, do you want me to scratch your back?
Yeah, yeah. Can you get two and give me a stranger? And Hayslip went down to Hotlanta to learn the secrets of the upcoming film Fast Five. Spoiler alert, I don't know where that hand has been. You don't know where mine's been, though. The cars go really fast.
Okay, buddy.
My ass has been in the seat of some pretty sweet rides, but this is a 1970 Dodge Charger, which can only mean I'm one place. The set of Fast Five, baby.
Brasil, andre mia via, pocato, pocato, hey.
If you thought the Fast and Furious franchise was out of gas, think again. The crew is back with slicker rides, new locales, and bigger heists. It's rare that a franchise makes it to 5 films, and yeah, you guys are still going strong. So how are you guys just upping the ante for each film?
It all happened with the cameo of Tokyo Drift, because I was never going to come back to this, the franchise. In my mind, they were going further and further away from the core of the story. So one of the executives from Universal came up to my house and said, listen, we want you just to do a cameo. We're never going to make another Fast and Furious unless you want to produce one. I said, I do want to produce one. And now we're here for the 5th film.
Oh, we got to stop. All right.
Can I just say one thing?
Yeah.
Allison?
Yes.
You have one of the best noses that I've seen in 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 years.
Thank you, sir. Fast and Furious 5, I feel like we've brought the band back together. It's like everyone is a part of this, huh? Yeah,
if it's not broken, don't fix it, you know, kind of thing. And people wanted more, so we brought one more.
What do you say, Dom? Are
we talking or are we racing?
I think there's things that have happened in this one that people have been wanting to see for a long time. And I'm just going to say that without giving away too much. And then we brought in Dwayne Johnson.
You're going down, Toretto.
I'm right here.
We've got trains in this one. We've got more set pieces. Being able to shoot in Brazil, and I'm speaking Portuguese in it. There's more action, too. I mean, Paul and I are, like, jumping off buildings, and that was really fun. I never knew how much fun I'd have with that kind of stuff.
Something about the formula of the franchise, which is cars, muscles, really sexy women, really sexy guys. I'm not the sexy guy piece of it. I'm just kind of the extra in the background.
Not sexy at all.
But, you know, it's a formula.
So what we're talking about is $100 million.
You say what?
I don't think that was supposed to happen. I think he was supposed to make that turn and crash on the other side.
We're doing it again.
There's a lot of close calls that happen on set. I mean, we even caught one today.
Yeah, well, that's one where I'm supposed to scrape the front of the car, and the wheel caught on the pole. I mean, it stopped me in a nanosecond.
This is Brazil!
The people, I guess, on the inside here don't think of it as a 5th film. They think of it as the 2nd film of the 2nd trilogy.
Well, then it also sounds like there has to be a 3rd
yes,
of
there
the
is.
Second trilogy.
Oh.
we're going to be seeing Fast and Furious 6, or?
With characters you might think are long.
Ooh, like your car?
Better than that.
Fast 5, the fifth installment of Fast and Furious. It's never been faster or furious, or more fast and more furious. You know what I mean.
Mortal Kombat.
Oh, your folks are here. Hey.
They're the Herder Clan. They're not. Everybody's in a stage manager.
But everybody turned around and was like, are they? Why didn't we say hi earlier? This is, we feel terrible about this.
Mortal Kombat, the 47th game in the franchise.
Yes, very true. 47.
The ninth title, actually, in the fighting series. Came out last week. In terms of the storyline, which we all know is the most important part of any fighting game, is this a reboot of the series? Is this a reimagining?
Did you say story? There's like a story?
Yeah, apparently there's something where you cannot skip long cutscenes.
Oh,
that's
yeah.
What I played.
Oh, the story mode. Yeah, the part that I hated. Yeah, so it's the retelling of the first three games, the storyline, or if you're familiar with the movies at all, you should definitely go watch the first one. I think they made some other ones. They were garbage, so don't watch those. But basically, it's a retelling of the first three games. Like you said, though, the downside, the first playthrough of the story mode, which is about 8 hours long, you cannot skip through any of the terrible cutscenes, which is terrible. But the pro to the story mode is that it kind of forces you to play through the game with almost every character. So it kind of gives you an idea of how everybody plays, and it shows you just how much you can appreciate how different a lot of the characters are.
Right. It lets me know that I'm going to suck no matter who I select at that character screen. Because I'm terrible at fighting games. Like, I make no mistake about it, I suck. Right? I can barely master Sub-Zero's little freeze ball, and that's about it. For guys like me, will this franchise take me under its little feathery wing? Will this title teach me how to play and groom me?
Yeah, you know, I think you can kind of consider this the Marvel vs. Capcom 3 of this particular franchise in that, you know, experts are going to really appreciate the depth that this game has to offer, but it is definitely a pick-up-and-play type of thing. As you can see right here, by far the most beautiful engine this game has ever had. I think personally, and Matt Kyle, who is our kind of G4 and X-Play fighting game expert, considers this to be the best Mortal Kombat game of all time.
Yeah, everybody seems to be saying that.
And I think in a lot of ways it is. They've done little things like they've kind of removed the diagonal from a lot of the combos, so you kind of got to retrain yourself if you've played in the past to not use diagonals. It might throw people off with a stick, but other than that, it's super easy to pull off a lot of the fatalities and combos.
Now, here's the thing. They always, and we'll get to the fatalities and the combos, because that's the bread and butter, obviously.
Absolutely.
But they always say there's 500 different game modes in this thing, and 400 unlockables, and roulette wheels that you can spin, and all sorts of modifiers. But when I went to training, I thought, okay, great, this is going to teach me how to play the game. It didn't really do that. It kind of shows you a handful of moves and then lets you wild.
Right. You know, I think that, first of all, one of the things we talked about, you played on the 360, right?
I did, yeah.
Important to point out that the combos, for some reason, I felt like the 360 controller wasn't as responsive as the PS3
controller. I'm hearing that a lot, yeah.
So the combos are a lot harder to pull off. But you're right. I mean, it never really teaches you to string anything together. It just shows you individual snippets of how you should actually fight. But you have to actually kind of move into the modes to put everything together. Like you said, there's 1,000 modes in this.
Right.
You know, there's a traditional ladder mode, which people of the game in the past are going to be familiar with. The story mode, like we said, which is just really tough to get through.
The PS3 has this awesome offline, online error code screen.
Yeah, that's pretty
cool. Which is really cool.
And apparently, if you play on the PS3, if you put in your credit card information, somebody else will spend your money.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
So it's like a fatality for your credit score.
Exactly.
Oh,
exactly. So that's pretty
Sony.
Fun. But a lot of the other modes, you know, the kind of challenge tower mode is pretty unique. There's like 300 to 1,000. I can't remember, so I'm using a very broad spectrum there.
It's in
but
there.
It's kind of challenging you to do different things to play through. And then you collect coins to unlock things in the crypt, which is kind of their online shopping center, or is, like we said, the PSN network, that other dude's online shopping center.
Yeah, exactly. The error screen.
Yeah.
What about the, like, we mentioned fatalities. fatalities and X-ray moves. Mm-hmm. What are these additions? And obviously, fatalities aren't addition, but the X-ray moves.
Right. Well, first of all, the fatalities are back to old school, gruesome, right. awesome Mortal Kombat fatalities, and not in the kind of shticky, like, let's get as ridiculous as possible. But like, that's what a Mortal Kombat fatality should be right there, yeah. man.
Congressmen should be getting in angry debates about video
Absolutely.
Games, and this one should do it.
Now you point out the X-ray moves. The X-ray moves are both good and bad. On the bad side of things, you know, there's a certain flow to fighting games,
right.
and when you unleash one of these X-ray moves, like you see right here, it completely interrupts the flow of the game. But on the positive side of things, if you're not good at fighting games, like you said, you are, X-ray moves take about 40%
right.
of health
they can
off
really
the other
turn
character.
The tide.
Really can. So it's almost like a strategy addition more than anything else.
And they do.
And
look
that's
pretty
awesome,
damn
dude.
Cool. Yeah. That's,
hey, you know
that's
what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna reach into you, freeze your spleen, and then yank it out, and then laugh at you while I headbutt your face. Right. I don't know why more fighting games don't embrace that particular technique.
I couldn't agree more. What did X-Play actually give the game?
X-Play gave it a 5 out of 5.
Oh!
For good reason. You know, the story mode, like I said, while I didn't agree with a lot of the writing in it, it does force you to play through most of the characters, and with a cast this large, it's cool that the game kind of makes you move through that. And then if you have the PS3, don't go online, but it does have Kratos as a PS3
as an unlockable. Yeah, that's cool.
And he is a hell of a lot of fun to play with.
Awesome.
So, yeah.
Awesome. Blair Herder, everybody.
Yay!
Thank you so much. Good soon.
Thank you very much.
Mortal Kombat is, of course, out right now, but let's go over to Canvas.
Still ahead, how much money has already been stolen from your PlayStation Network users? Kristen Adams has the answer in today's feed. Hey, Kristen.
Hi.
And then Mark Ruffalo is here live. She's like an old lady.
Yesterday on the show, we were giving away an HTC Inspire 4G from AT&T, and the winner is Daniel R. from San Antonio, Texas. Congratulations, and keep watching Attack of the Show for more epic giveaways.
Just look at the faces on everyone, and just how excited everyone is. Bruce, did you enjoy my singing? He's a mute. He's mute.
What up? I'm Kristen Adams. It's Wednesday, April 27th, and here are your top stories. It's day 8 of the PlayStation Network's woes, and some users have already had their bank accounts breached. I know, so sad. Only a day after Sony admitted to PSN users' personal data being hacked, some members have reported up to $600 missing from the bank account they had linked to PSN. Meanwhile, Sony is defending themselves for taking so long to inform users of the breach and say they had to confirm the external intrusion with outside experts before making it public. Does that mean there's no internal experts? I'm confused. Even so, a class action lawsuit has already been filed against Sony, so if you have a PSN account, remember to change any shared passwords and keep an eye on your bank account and credit card statements. For more info, head to g4tv.com/PSN. Apple has finally responded to the controversy surrounding the hidden file on iPhones and iPads that tracks users' location history for up to a year. And the good thing, because 2 years ago, you do not want to know where I was. Okay. In their official statement, Apple said they do not continuously track users. The tracking file is actually a database of the nearest Wi-Fi hotspots and cell towers, which is used to supplement the GPS to help the device find its location quicker. But if you're still paranoid, worry not. Apple said a software update is on the way that will address security concerns. You just have to punch in all your personal information before you can get that update. In other Apple news, if you've been eagerly awaiting the white iPhone, you're in luck. It goes on sale tomorrow. That makes everything okay, right? I'll take two. And finally, the new trailer for X-Men First Class just hit the web today. Pretty sweet. And it's got more completed effects and more action than ever before, not to mention a little extra Emma Frost. Take a look.
Have the chance to become part of something much bigger than yourself.
What do you know about me?
Everything.
A new species is being born.
Help me guide it. Shape it. Lead it.
Time for the tour.
You have no idea what I'd give to feel
normal.
You want society to accept you, but you can't even accept yourself.
Should we have to hide?
Tomorrow, mankind will know that mutants exist. They'll fear us, and that fear will turn to hatred.
Not if we stop a war. Not if we risk our lives doing so. We have it in us to be the better men.
We already are.
It shall be the policy of this nation to regard any nuclear missile launched from Cuba as an attack by the Soviet Union on the United States.
They're just kids.
No, they were kids.
You ready for this?
Let's find out.
The cost of freedom is always high. No one can foresee precisely what course it will take. One path we shall never choose, and that is the path of surrender.
Listen to me very carefully, my friend. Killing will not bring you peace.
Peace was never an option.
That's pretty cool, right? I like it. I just want that soundtrack playing, like, in my head wherever I go. Like, just, yeah, what? Okay, I'm Kristen Adams. I don't know. You've just been fed. Let's go back to those guys. They're funnier.
How often are you riding dirty wherever you go? You know, when I got my ghetto lane on the way to the dog washer. What up? Whole Foods?
The parade of Android tablets continues.
Today, it's this little guy.
Choosing a tablet is getting harder and harder these days. But T-Mobile thinks they've got the perfect choice, the G-Slate from LG. It's got an 8.9-inch multi-touch screen running on Android 3.0 for Google's best tablet experience. And it even has dual rear-facing cameras for 3D video recording. Also included is a front-facing camera, 32 gigs of storage, and 4G capability for $530 with a contract.
Okay, from the front, it looks like the G-Slate.
Oh, someone's on her way. Someone's on her way to Trader Joe's. Watch out.
It looks like the G-Slate is going for that iPad look. It's smaller than the iPad 2, but it's definitely heavier.
Yeah,
so how does this rate in the looks department for you?
I think it's all right. I wouldn't kick her out of bed. Here, there we go. Now that she's on. Go ahead. Do you want to hold her?
No, you can hold her.
Well, here's the thing. I wish it were a little lighter. Otherwise, yeah. The design is nice. It does feel a little heavy in this old day and age. The 9-inch screen is sharp and very bright. One small complaint, though. It has slots for micro USB and HDMI, but there's actually a proprietary charging hole right there. So you can charge it. Yeah, this tiny little guy right there, the old chili hole. You can charge it via USB, but it's gonna take a day to fully charge this thing through USB, which is crazy.
A long time.
So you gotta carry around that cord if you want, and then the extra cord to actually charge it in a decent amount of time.
Okay, now what about the interface?
Interface is great. I mean, it's standard Android Honeycomb, which is the version of Android that's made specifically for tablets. It looks and acts just like the Motorola Zoom tablet that reviewed a few weeks back. Mm-hmm. Web browsing is just as good as any Android tablet, and this one has Flash support, which is great. And it actually churns through Flash pretty well. I had Pink Lab up and running, and was able to browse a handful of the stuff.
You showed me that
earlier.
Yeah. Oh, so gross. The G-Slate has the same dual-core 1 gigahertz Tegra 2 processor that the Zoom has. So how does it perform? Stop chuckling at yourself.
It's bittersweet, because I know time I'll be able to mention it until, like, S&P kills it from here on out. So at least I got my one in. It's pretty fast. The Tegra 2 is now a requirement for many of the newest apps in the Android markets. And it's nice to buy a tablet and not have to worry about whether it can run something. Mm-hmm. I mean, that's a terrible feeling to get a brand new device and go, oh, it chugs with this game. Yeah. And here you can see we loaded up some processor-intensive games. That's QWERTY running on the old G-Slate. And it ran it with only a couple stutters, which was nice.
Now let's get to the big selling points.
Let's do
it. First, 4G wireless. Mm-hmm. Is it worth it?
Definitely, sorta.
I'll get to that in a second.
Wait a minute.
Here's the thing. If it's available in your area and you can afford it, get it. The 4G service from T-Mobile is blazing fast. As fast, sometimes even faster than Wi-Fi. So kudos to that. But good luck, you know, affording rent after you sign up for it. We'll get to that in a second.
Okay, now the other selling point, it has a 3D video camera.
Whoa.
Does anyone really need a 3D camera?
When you're watching future movies, yes.
Love these glasses.
No one needs a 3D camera. It is a neat trick for it to have. The videos can be recorded and viewed with the cheap red and blue hipster glasses. But if you have a better 3D television and the shutter glasses, you can view them that way and plug it into HDMI. I mean, it looks okay, but it's not like, I'm sure commercials will tout this as the only tablet with 3D, but you don't need to be a tablet with 3D yet.
Okay.
So there you have it.
Yeah, I like mine better. You look kind of goofy.
What are you what?
All right, let's talk price. How much is it?
Here's where things really fall apart. Without a contract, you're going to be shelling out $750. That's $150 more than the 32 gig iPad 2. Now, if you sign up for a 2-year contract, it's $530. But here's the thing. It's going to cost you $30 a month for the 200 meg 4G plan and $50 a month for the 5 gig plan. Now, some of these games are well over a gig to download. So if you download a game or two and a couple songs here and stream a YouTube video there, or you're visiting the old P-Lab, you're going to run out of bandwidth in no time, and that's ridiculous.
Oh, Kevin, what are we rating it?
3 out of 5. I think it's great hardware that's crippled with pretty poor agreements. They really need to get the price down. It's a great tablet, but at this price, you have to decide if you want to spend more for an Android tablet or just go with the iPad too. All right, folks. That was migraine-inducing. No, I'm not. That's it for today's Gadget Prawn. But if you have a gadget you'd like to see us rate, email us at gadgetprawn@g4tv.com.
Stay tuned. The Hulk just directed his first movie.
Yes, Mark Ruffalo is here live. Coming up now. Yeah.
If you've been missing Ninja Warrior, don't worry. The 26th Ninja Warrior tournament will be here very, very soon. If you're ready, willing, and able to take on the Ninja Warrior course, let's face it, you're probably a little bit crazy. But that's why we love Ninja Warrior. You never know what's going to happen next or who you might see on the course. If you think the Ninja Warrior course is crazy, wait until you get a load of the competitors. Ninja Warrior has wacky comedians and tough ninjas. It's got the Octopus Man and Superman and, hey, even Spider-Man. It's got beautiful women.
Don't stop.
And Olympic athletes. Skinny guys and not so skinny guys. And it also has these guys. But everyone who competes has talent and the desire to beat this course. Okay, well, I'm not sure about that guy.
Hey!
We watch Ninja Warrior to see our heroes perform amazing athletic feats. But we also love it because we are guaranteed some comic relief. But no matter what our favorite part of Ninja Warrior is, we all have one thing in common. We're all waiting to see if one person out of 100 has what it takes to go all the way, climb the tower, and achieve total victory.
The feed is brought to you by the General Automobile Insurance Services. For the best car insurance rates online, go to the General and save some time.
Fail. You're dead. Major fail. Fail. Fail, 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 fail. You lose.
I didn't know you could make a movie with a priest and not have an exorcism, but guess what? Mark Ruffalo did it.
Hello, Dean. Have a minute?
My man. Father, this is him.
Yeah.
This is the man. He's the one. No, youngin. You raised me up.
Brendel's had a spontaneous healing, Dean, of his gout and his Alzheimer's.
What are you talking about, man? What?
I don't know what this is. Listen, please. I mean, you don't know what you did. My man, look, you got the healing touch.
I got nothing to do with you, man.
I want to thank you. And I want to thank you.
I got nothing to do with you. I didn't do anything.
Okay. All right, let's break it up here. There's nothing to see. Dean had nothing to do with this.
Oh, but he did. Joining me now, Mark Ruffalo, everybody. Welcome to the old show, good sir.
Thank you, man.
Been a fan for a long while. It's a pleasure to finally sit and have a chat with you.
Thank you.
Let's start with Sympathy for Delicious. This is a film that near and dear to you, to say the least, but it's been in the work for a while, right?
It's been 10 years since I was given the script by my friend Christopher Thornton.
It was written on papyrus.
Yes.
And he handed it to you.
And it was a scroll. But it was actually several scrolls.
You had to translate.
It was 197 pages that he handed me.
Really?
Yes.
And so did you cheat
margins.
Size 24 font in triple space. Yeah.
No, yeah. And it was just one solid block of writing.
You're like, hey, buddy, this is a trailer. Why don't we put some dialogue in here and make it? Did you really help shape the direction of the film and the script itself?
Yeah, a lot of the 10 years of trying to get it made was honing that down to what the story was that we wanted to tell. There was a lot in there.
Yeah, it's you try to cover many things, and it kind of comes down to we were just talking really very quickly before the interview started about the road to hell is paved with good intentions.
That's right.
Which is that the ultimate kind of notion of the film, that you could have the best intentions in the world but ultimately still be a flawed person or lead a flawed existence?
Who isn't? Except for you.
I'm not throwing stones.
No. You can't in here.
No, exactly.
You'd break something. You know, it's that, and in the end, you get what you need, maybe sometimes in life, not what you want.
Right.
And it's a road. It's a selfish man who through redemption, does one selfless act in the end of the movie, you know?
Yeah.
And... But all the healing and stuff—that was stuff that Chris Thornton tried when he first had his accident.
He's really a paraplegic, and he phenomenal actor too.
Yes, I mean,
by the way,
actor,
like just an incredible performance. But he actually went to faith healers and tried all that stuff.
Yeah, yeah, in his desperation to be healed, and it was crazy. Because it really was the guy who comes out in the silk suit with the gold rings and just has his band with him and, like, busts out in song between healings.
Right.
And
but I'm sure the band for the faith healer he saw was not, like, a hardcore grunge group with a mosh pit, right?
No.
It was a little more evangelical.
I was like, that's what I want to see.
Right, exactly.
Why hasn't anyone done that?
That was a traveling sideshow circus there, and I love that vibe. But speaking of guys in suits, you're going to be playing a role very soon. I'm told it's the Hulk. Yeah! In the Avengers?
Yes, that's right.
Will you be donning a suit for this role?
I will. I brought part of my costume with me
nice.
Today.
Is
right now. Here it is.
This may be an exclusive.
Yes! Smash! Smash!
All right, Mark Ruffalo, please! I submit! Was that a Hulk jockitch right there? Was that a cup adjust?
It was an adjustment.
Right.
It was a Hulk adjustment.
Adjustment to the old green machine. How are you guys?
Jolly green midget.
This is the first time Hulk is going to be mo-capped, right?
Yeah, I'll be the first actor to actually play the Hulk.
That's incredible.
Yeah, it's cool.
And for Bruce Banner, is there like a Hulk diet to actually play Hulk, where it's like just protein and human growth hormone and
yes,
you know, Jamba Juice, Barry Bonds?
Yes. Yeah. Yeah. There is.
What did you have to do to actually get ready for your Hulk?
Well, it kind of was shoved upon me. I received a package in the mail from my manager, and I thought, well, that's a big package for an iPad.
All right.
But maybe they packed it really well in there.
Right.
And I opened it up, and it was like a whole diet system.
What?
And it was like just protein shakes and and they put me on like a 28. I was like, are you trying to tell me something? No.
No.
No, you look great.
Yeah.
And they put me on a 28-day diet that it was no sugar, no caffeine, no dairy, no wheat.
No sex, no drugs, no wine, no women.
Oh, no.
No fun,
no sin. That's when you turn the roll down. That's when you say no thank you.
Yes, exactly. You know? I was like, really?
I could do South Beach for a while, but no sex and drugs.
What about CGI?
Exactly.
I didn't plan to do this stuff anymore.
Exactly. I want to chat with you for an hour because there's so many topics to cover, but very quickly, I love that you are an activist and a half, that you use every platform you have to forward social good and change. And I'm just wondering, what's you think the issue right now? I know there's many. There's a handful of plates spinning, but is there one right now that is particular or near and dear to you?
Well, I've been fighting this hydraulic fracturing, this gas extraction they've been doing. And
people call it fracking, and our audience thinks that's Battlestar sex.
Yeah, I know.
But it's not. This is actually a very dangerous practice.
This is fricking fracking.
Right.
And, you know, it's a way to extract natural gas using millions of gallons of water blasted into the earth at high pressures, laced with 150,000 gallons of fracking fluid, which contains carcinogens, neurotoxins, and this stuff's ending up in people's drinking water.
In their drinking water, yeah.
And they want to do it up and down the Delaware River, which is where 15.6 million people get their drinking water. And nobody wants to study it beforehand.
But don't worry, they've got it in bottles now. We're fine. We're totally safe.
We can buy it.
That'll sustain us forever.
Yes, yes.
Wow. So, I encourage everybody to...
And the Indian Point, nuclear power plant is aged. It's, if it blows up in America, like what happened in Fukushima, we're looking at a major, major disaster. They have no evacuation plan for that area. Most of our problems... Mm-hmm. For us and the people we're talking to, our energy problems.
Right.
And that's going to be our, that'll be the battle cry of our generation, is how we're going to go from carbon fuel to greener alternatives.
Well, if you're on the front lines with a spear and shield, sir, I will run behind you and scream right along with everybody else. Mark Ruffalo, pleasure, sir. Sorry, we're out of time. You got to come back. We got to chat some more. Mark Ruffalo, Sympathy for Delicious. Opens in theaters on Friday. Stick around. More Attack right after this. Thank you. That was really good. So sorry we got...
Yes, wait. Keep picking it up with
the air
the glove. Yeah. How does it feel?
I feel a little lightheaded, but it feels good.
What a show!
What a show, what a show. Thanks to our guests, Mark Ruffalo, Allison Hayson, Claire Herter, and Kristen Adams.
All right, here's the thing. This is very important. You guys need to stick around. Why? Great question. An all-new episode of Web Soup is going to start right now.
Yay!
And who wouldn't want to stick around for that?
I love it.
I'm going to go watch it with Mark Ruffalo right now.